Hi, I'm Phil, and today we're going to look at Airbit 2. And we'll just look at its description, what it does. So you can use this as a drone controlled by Microbit. And the company that made it comes from Norway. They're called Make Kit, and you get about 8 minutes flight, 7 to 8 minutes when the battery is fully charged. Now, the most important sensor is a one on the extra board. So there's not only Microbit, but just under Microbit, there's a controller board, and it uses a 6-axis IMU, three of those for the accelerometer and the other three for the gyro. And there you could control this with a Android or a iPad, or alternatively you can use a second Microbit and use the roll and pitch controlled by that Microbit's accelerometer. And that's what I'm going to do in the videos that we see later on. So the overall cost, I bought this from Education Technology Specialists, and it's also available from Core Electronics. So I'll be using this in the STEM clubs, and there's quite a lot of principles involved in all the branches of STEM, the mathematics, science, and programming, even in art, where a lot of the materials that are used to try and get the weight down, a plywood, quite a multi-layer plywood is used in the construction of that. So if we actually look at the kit, these are the parts that you get to put it all together. You can see it's quite lightweight. The motors are probably the heaviest part, and there's very little metal. So the frame is made of plywood. So it comes with everything you need, except you need to add for control the two microbits and a microbit battery box. The assembly wise, they provide some tools and the overall diagram. The most important thing is the control board, and the five holes on the bottom there connect to the large holes near the bottom of the microbit. So you can see it c can control the left motors, one on the front, one on the back, and the right motors. It also has the provision for adding two servo motors, and these can be used for other projects like the hover bit. And in that control board, the most important sensor is the 6-axis IMU, and it does the tracking. So it comes from a company called TDK, and it's quite a tiny little chip that goes on that control board. So you get about 1% accuracy in the gyro measurements. Some of the other accessories that are available include getting spare parts in case you need it. But a very interesting one is the Wi-Fi camera. And it can be attached to the drone, and it can take pictures, and you can see those pictures on your Wi-Fi screen. So let's have a look at the projects. Now, I initially had problems commissioning, but got a bit of help from Make Kit, and I was able to commission this and check out that it did what it should do. So you can see my arrangement here. I've got a drone with a control board, And there's my control board. So I'm using a control board a little bit more elaborate than just the micro:bit on its own. And we might actually look at some of the code for that. So I'm not going to look at the code for both. This is the control or the transmitter, the remote control. And you can see it's sending out messages using the micro:bit radio. And right at the beginning, we're setting up the radio group to be 6, which is set up on both the drone micro:bit and also on the remote controller. And the actual image on the micro:bit LED array is similar on both the remote control micro:bit and the drone micro:bit. So you can see the protocol. We use a play or a pitch, arm, roll, and throttle. And the Y in play is the yaw, and that can be added. It's not added in this case, but that can be an extension that allows you to rotate the drone around about the vertical axis. Okay, so stay tuned and we'll have a look at it trying to take off. This is Airbit version 2, and it's using the micro:bit computer with a control board that comes from Make It Kits. On the back, we've got a LiPo battery, 800 milliamp hours, and this model here that I've got has no propeller guards, so I need to fit those on, but they're quite hard to fit on, and you end up with sore fingers trying to put them on. This one here has got the propeller guards on it, and what we're going to do, we'll just do a very simple demonstration, and it needs a remote control, so we'll turn them both on. We'll turn the remote control on. Can see it's on channel 6 at the moment, and we'll plug in the power to our drone. Now that we've got the power cable connected to the control board, we're ready to fly. And you'll notice that we've got similar images on both the remote control. The middle indicates the roll and the pitch. So when I move the roll, when I actually tilt it, you can see that it's changing. The dot, the central dot, goes up and down and left and right depending on the roll. And that movement is also shown on the drone itself. So when I move the pitch in one direction or the other, and the roll, you can see that central dot changes. And the right bar indicates the amount of power in the battery. So we've got a full battery here. And we're just about ready to go. So what I'm going to do is press button A and B together, and it should turn on the power. So you can see the power, and the propellers are moving. And to increase the thrust, I go to my remote control and press button B. Now I won't take off because I'm already using both hands, and what I'll do is just just button A and B again, and it will shut it off.
Oh my God, that's it. This is too small place.
Too small here, isn't it? Just one more.